guys, welcome back to my channel. So today in this video lecture, we are going to study about autonomic nervous system. And this video basically includes the introduction part in which we'll study the divisions of ANS and the actions of all the divisions. So as you can see, our nervous system is divided into two, central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. Our autonomic nervous system is a part of peripheral nervous system, okay? The central nervous system includes brain and spinal cord. When it comes to peripheral nervous system, it is divided into two, somatic and autonomic. Somatic mainly supplies the muscles, as you can see here, and it is voluntary in nature, okay? And whereas our autonomic nervous system, it works below the conscious level, okay? It is subconscious and it is involuntary in nature. Activities of this system are maintained autonomically. That's why we call it autonomic nervous system, okay? The three main divisions of ANS, it includes parasympathetic nervous system, sympathetic nervous system, and the enteric nervous system. You might be knowing about these two, but most of the people forget about enteric nervous system when it comes to autonomic nervous system. So yes, friends, enteric nervous system, which is present in our GI tract, is also a part of autonomic nervous system. Divisions of ANS into sympathetic and parasympathetic is anatomical in origin. Fibers of sympathetic system originate from thoracic and lumbar spinal cord, that is from T1 to L2, as you can see over here. And it is basically divided into three parts. Okay, the transmission of the impulse occurs into three parts. First of all, we are having preganglionic neurons, okay? Then there will be a ganglionic neurons, okay? And then the target tissues. So in this way, in three steps, the transmission of the nerve impulse occurs, okay? First of all, we have preganglionic fibers. In the sympathetic division, we have T1 to L2, okay? Which are taking part into sympathetic nervous system, or the sympathetic division, and they relay into a different ganglia like sympathetic chain ganglia, collateral ganglia, or the adrenal medulla. Through adrenal medulla, we have neurohumoral transmission. Okay, adrenal medulla releases epinephrine and norepinephrine. We have already studied in our hormonal lecture on adrenal, right? So these two hormones, they are related with our sympathetic nervous system, adrenaline and noradrenaline, right? And it will get released from adrenal medulla. So this way, neurohumoral transmission is also a part of sympathetic division. In the parasympathetic division of ANS, it includes cranial nerves, which are 3, 7, 9, and 10. Do remember these three, okay? These three cranial nerves are associated with our parasympathetic division of ANS, which are at oculomotor, facial, glossopharyngeal, and vagus. And they refer to the particular ganglia, okay? Which are a ciliary ganglion for our oculomotor nerve, pterygopalatine or the submandibular ganglia for our facial nerve, otic ganglia for the glossopharyngeal nerve, and intramural ganglia for our vagus nerve. Apart from it, it has also a nuclei in spinal cord segment S2 to S4, okay? And the target organs, as you can see over here, so all these organs are supplied parasympathetically by these four cranial nerves, okay? And the visceral organs in inferior portion of abdominopelvic cavity, they are supplied by nuclei in the spinal cord segments from S2 to S4. In sympathetic system, post-ganglionic fibers, okay, as you can see, all these are our post-ganglionic fibers, okay. So this post-ganglionic fibers, they are either equal to or larger than our pre-ganglionic fibers, okay. Okay, but in the case of parasympathetic nervous system, our pre-ganglionic fibers are larger compared to post-ganglionic fibers, okay. So what does it mean? That our ganglia is near to the target organs in case of parasympathetic nervous system. So this is the first difference which we can see between the sympathetic and the parasympathetic transmission, okay, which is of post-ganglionic fibers and that of ganglia. Now the second thing, acetylcholine is the principal neurotransmitter at neuromuscular junctions as well as at all the preganglionic fibers, okay. As you can see, on all the preganglionic fibers, we have acetylcholine as a neurotransmitter in parasympathetic as well as in sympathetic nervous system. In parasympathetic system, neurotransmitter released at postganglionic site is also the acetylcholine. Okay, that's why our parasympathetic system is also referred as cholinergic system. Okay, why? Because of it has a neurotransmitter which is acetylcholine. That's why we call it cholinergic system. Okay, in sympathetic system, at most of the postganglionic fibers, neurotransmitter secreted is noradrenaline. Okay, noradrenaline. It comes from adrenal medulla. But it can be dopamine in case of renal vessels, or it could be epinephrine and norepinephrine. Okay, they get released from adrenals, as I said, adrenal medulla particularly. Okay, there is only one place where acetylcholine act as presynaptic neurotransmitter and the postsynaptic neurotransmitter in sympathetic nervous system, okay, which is on the sweat glands and the vessels. Okay, now most of the actions of the sympathetic and parasympathetic systems are opposite. Sympathetic system works when there is a fight or flight response. Okay, so in such cases our sympathetic activity will dominate, whereas in the resting state parasympathetic activity will dominate. And by both of this system, homeostasis is maintained in our autonomic nervous system. So what does sympathetic system do? To remember the major actions, we can assume that sympathy is related to heart. So sympathetic system stimulates it, okay? So we can see heart rate increases and force of contraction also increases in case of sympathetic nervous system. On the other hand, parasympathetic system has opposite action to depress the heart, okay, which is to decrease the heart rate and decrease the force of contraction. At most other parts, action is reverse. Okay, sympathetic system inhibits and the parasympathetic system stimulates. As you can see in the GIT, okay, we have decreased motility, spinal contraction and decreased secretions. So apart from heart, everywhere else sympathetic system will decrease everything and parasympathetic system increases except from the heart, okay. So here gastric motility increases, sphincter relaxation and the increased secretion is seen. And on the blood vessels, parasympathetic system has no effect, whereas sympathetic, it does the vasoconstriction, okay? Whereas in the lung, it does the opposite action, bronchodilation, okay? So when will our sympathetic system will be active? In case of fight or flight, okay? So in such situation, we need more air to breathe, so it causes bronchodilation. We can remember it like that way. Whereas parasympathetic, it does the bronchodilation. constrictions. And to increase the blood pressure, sympathetic system, what does it do? It does the vasoconstriction, whereas parasympathetic system has no effect on it. This you have to remember, guys. इसमें बहुत confusion हो जाता है कि mitriasis and meiosis पे कौन सा system mainly act कर रहा है, okay? So guys, how I have remembered it is parasympathetic, okay? It's a long word. So उसके साथ जो effect associated है, it is of smaller word, that is meiosis. ठीक है? Meiosis छोटा word है, वो अपने बड़े system के साथ, यानी कि parasympathetic के साथ associated है. Whereas sympathetic, जो कि small word है, उसके साथ the larger word is associated, which is mitriasis, okay? एंड ये भी आपको नहीं भूलना है कि मियोसिस मतलब क्या. देर इज़ अ कंस्ट्रिक्शन ऑफ प्यूपल, ओके? प्यूपल छोटी हो रही है. एंड इन द माइट्रियासिस देर इज डायलिटेशन ऑफ द प्यूपल. सो टू रिमेंबर दिस यू हैव टू लिंक इट एज माइट्रियासिस, ओके, इज अ लार्ज वर्ड. सो प्यूपल इज डायलेटिंग, प्यूपल बड़ी हो रही है. मियोसिस इज अ स्मॉलर वर्ड, सो इसमें प्यूपल छोटा हो रहा है, विच इज गेटिंग कंस्ट्रिक्टेड. ओके, सो दिस इज जस्ट अ ट्रिक टू रिमेंबर इट. यू कैन फाइंड योर ओन वे टू रिमेंबर इट, बट डोंट गेट कन्फ्यूज्ड. ओके, सो गाइज, दिस वॉज ऑल अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्टरी पार्ट ऑफ ANS. आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड इट.